I'm Alec Baldwin, and you're listening to Marketing Trends and the Leeds Art Week.
For years, the automotive industry has served as a beacon of America's thriving commerce industry. Now, that once thriving sector is facing a global chip shortage, which has caused automakers to slow production. With supply chains sputtering along, what does that mean for manufacturers such as GHSP, a company founded in 1924 with deep roots in providing automakers some of the key components used in everyday cars?
We're not able to necessarily provide the product that our customers are looking for. They're not always able to continue their production, yet the consumer is still wanting it. It's been unique in the sense that we aren't really looking for a lot of work. We're just looking to fulfill the work that we already have in terms of certainly in our auto space and in the markets and companies that we service.
John Major is the director of marketing at GHSP, and on this episode of Marketing Trends, he details how GHSP is reinvesting in itself by building up its marketing efforts. John also provides examples of how the company is expanding its product offerings by jumping into the appliance sector, and he details the marketing strategies they are using to build brand awareness and to target potential customers. Enjoy this episode. This message is brought to you by Salesforce. Hey marketers, today's B2B buyers are more complex than ever, and every buying committee has different needs and goals. Salesforce can help. We'll show you how to put each and every customer at the center of your B2B marketing strategy, and you'll learn how top brands like Lyft approach account-based marketing. Salesforce, market to every account, speak to every buyer. Find free B2B marketing and ABM resources at sfdc.co/every-buyer.
Welcome to Marketing Trends. I'm Ian Faison, host of Marketing Trends, and today we are joined by special guest, John. How are you?
Doing well. Thanks for having me, Ian.
Yeah, excited to have you on the show. Excited to chat about GHSP and all the cool stuff that you're doing there and get into your background. So how'd you get started in marketing?
I come from a little bit more of a production background. Grew up in the broadcast television world and before getting into art and design and eventually making a turn toward traditional marketing. So spanning over 25 plus years now, it's been kind of a long and windy road and one that's been really enjoyable.
Yeah. And so flash forward to today, tell us a little bit about your role at GHSP and for our listeners who don't know, more about the company.
Yeah. So GHSP is almost a 100-year-old company located in the west part of Michigan, lower peninsula of Michigan. And primarily the company has really had its roots in the automotive industry. Starting out from stamping metal, that's actually what the GHSP stands for, is Grand Haven Stamped Products. The company was originally located in Grand Haven, Michigan, and they stamped metal products into shifters for automobiles. And the company has really made a lot of turns, a lot of innovations over the years. As the auto started to evolve, so did GHSP, and some of the areas that really speak out in mind in some of those changes is changes with the electrification of the car, getting more into electronics. We started seeing that change to move from mechanical devices and shifting to one that is electronically controlled. And so we started making really a lot of change into that area. And as a matter of fact, now we employ more software engineers than mechanical engineers. And all the big foundry type rooms of stamping presses and everything are now white clean rooms. And where we're printing our own circuit boards and have actually become one of the leaders in cybersecurity in the auto industry. So the company has really changed a lot over almost 100 years now. And more recently, we've had a shift into diversification that's even getting us into other markets. And that's really what drove the need for additional marketing. And so that's really where I came on board and started building out a marketing organization here that spans across all of our facilities globally.
Yeah. And so tell us a little bit more about what you do for marketing, who are your customers and all that.
So we primarily work with all of the major OEM auto manufacturers around the globe. Everything, of course, in the Detroit area, being a Michigan-based company, we have a lot of strong access and have worked with the main Detroit auto manufacturers for the bulk of the company's life, but are also into other areas around the globe, work with all of the OEMs in Japan, China now, and in Europe as well. So, and for marketing, we're really always looking to strengthen products that we currently have and expand the product set with our current customers. Now we're starting to diversify into more electronically based markets that have brought us into the controls for high-end kitchen appliances.
And so what goes into a shift like that in marketing? I'd imagine that's a totally different, demographic of customers and prospects. It's a different shift in messaging. A lot of different things go into that.
Yeah, there's a pretty significant change. From being a traditional auto tier one auto supplier, those relationships have been built for a lot of years, and they know who we are. We know who they are. We've had longstanding good relationships. But getting into a new market like appliance really provided some challenges that we really had to work on, and that was just trying to establish ourselves and build a brand that really wasn't known to anyone in that space. And that was, going back to just creating a marketing organization here, that was what really drove the need for that. And we've spent a lot of time in the brand building of that space in not only automotive, but more so into appliance now, to get known and help those OEMs understand what our capabilities are and how a lot of what we do in the auto space actually has a really good relatability into the appliance space. So it's an ongoing process that has really started to show some fruit along the way.
And so how do you think about campaigns? What goes into one of your marketing campaigns?
Our campaigns end up being quite targeted toward the markets that we're going after. We can get fairly granular in specifics within the OEM industry and auto. And then as we started looking more toward appliance, we found it somewhat similar. And we ended up really structuring a lot of our campaigns to go after specific OEMs or manufacturers that we wanted to work with. And so we really started trying to single out exactly who those companies were. We started identifying who the key players were in those companies. And then we started getting very, very targeted in some of the campaigns to try to help them understand who we are and what we do, and try to open some doors into some more dialogue with them.
Yeah. When you're going through that type of change, are you doing a lot of like testing and iterating on initial messaging and, testing in the market? How did you think about that?
Yeah. So we actually do a lot of testing as we're entering new markets. Another area that we've been in more recently and kind of a startup for us is UVC disinfecting light. And getting into a space like that, especially with a pandemic that we've been going through, making sure the products are working, understanding what the market is really looking for, providing safety aspects to it, and helping to educate the overall market and the end users has been something that's been really at the forefront of what we've been doing. For example, we're working with a company called May Mobility that's based out of Grand Rapids, using autonomous shuttle services that's hopefully expanding across the country. We've been able to utilize them in a pretty significant way to test a lot of our products in that space and generate real feedback from end users and getting a better understanding through different surveys with them on what customers feel safe, what they're looking for, what type of systems that they are looking for in providing a safe, clean environment in their vehicles.
And obviously, like in the past year, sales has changed dramatically. How did sales change for you all? How did you, as director of marketing, support the sales team?
Yeah, the auto industry historically is a pretty cyclical market. And, you know, the past year has been really interesting because, you know, we've gone through sections of production being shut down due to COVID. Now we're facing, you know, chip shortages and not being able to get the silicon we need to help support some of our customers. But yet demand from the overall market, the end consumer, has still been strong. So it's provided a really interesting and unique market right now where we're not able to necessarily provide the product that our customers are looking for. They're not always able to continue their production, yet the consumer is still wanting it. And so it's been unique in the sense that we aren't really looking for a lot of work. We're just looking to fulfill the work that we already have in terms of certainly in our auto space and the markets and companies that we service. So it's really been a unique, you know, set of circumstances that we've had to navigate to keep things moving here and look for ways to support our customers.
Yeah. So you mentioned some of the work that you were doing as you were rolling out new products and things like that. Mm-hmm. What does your process look like for those sort of things? I know this is something that's always on the top of mind for a lot of marketers is how do we have a new product launch coming up. Maybe it's different from something we already have. Maybe it's a different demographic. But yeah, what did that process look like for you?
Yeah, our launches are kind of an interesting aspect, and it depends on the area that we're going into. We have an innovation team that we created a couple of years back that are really dedicated to looking at newer technologies and helping to create areas that help us reach into either new markets or expand on existing ones that we're in. And they also double as helping to support launches into some of the new products that we're working on with our OEM partners. One of the things being more of a B2B company and working through longstanding relationships with the auto industry and the OEMs there, a lot of our launches are supported directly, and they're much more of a strong relationship and a kind of a back and forth with our OEM customers. And so it's a little bit different than launching into a consumer market directly. One that we've found to work really, really well because of the strong relationships that we've built with our customers over many years. So we also have a much longer launch timeline that ends up spanning out upwards of 18 months. So it ends up being a pretty significant longer process that a lot of people in other markets don't experience.
And what channels do you look at for marketing this sort of thing? Like, what are you experimenting with?
We're always looking for what consumers are wanting. If we look specifically in the auto industry and we look at our core product lines that primarily are shifting and as well as other products like pumps and actuators that help control vehicles, helping us understand what consumers are comfortable with to control their vehicle becomes a big driver for us. As an example, historically, a shifter that you mechanically move from park into drive and into reverse and so on. Are there other ways that can be handled that are more intuitive or safer? But are there ways that the customer is okay with that and they feel safe with it? Safety is such a big aspect of what we do when we're looking at vehicle control. So we're constantly looking at our end users that use the products and buy the automobiles that our direct customers sell, and we're looking for that feedback as to how they receive the product and really how they're comfortable or what their comfort level is with newer and different ways of controlling the vehicle.
Jumping back to some other times in your career, you've been in various different marketing roles at other companies. Do you have any favorite campaigns that you ran or favorite marketing initiatives that were some of the best?
Yeah, it's funny. You look back on those and, everyone is so different and trying to find, a favorite one. I think one of the things that is actually a little more recent that comes to mind is launching a inductive cooktop that we currently are still working with at GHSP here. The thing that was so unique about this is basically we're taking a product that we developed that cooks through magnetics and is able to heat very rapidly and very precisely. But then we put it through a 55-inch OLED video screen. And so you can bring to market something that what we refer to as the world's most entertaining cooktop. And when you start thinking about all the possibilities and everything from an appliance OEM being able to brand this through video right on your cooktop, the thing that was so unique about this product was the engagement with end users. You could just see the excitement that people were able to bring to you know, see this product and you know, want it immediately. And we were able to gauge from our initial launch just, you know, what the overall product demand is going to be. We started seeing the connection that people were having in a more personal way in how they could interact with this and really bring it into the center of their home, the kitchen area that's becoming the center of people's homes. And so it was one that was really interesting being able to see real-time feedback through a launch and a campaign of this type of product and being able to see the type of excitement that we were getting right out of the gate was pretty interesting and fun to be a part of.
You know, those new inventions, those new type of things, you know, making things like CES's coolest gadgets list and things like that. Like, yeah. How do you think about marketing those sort of things? Because they're so, I feel like we're so used to seeing these kind of cool new things. You see them kind of on like Instagram every day now. I mean, it seems like there's a lot of different like ways to do that, but maybe it's information overload on how many different places to look at putting those things or using influencers or using all that sort of stuff.
Yeah, it's always the big challenge being able to, you know, find that niche or that product that I think will resonate when you're looking at a show like CES, because that's, you know, that's the place everyone goes to launch those products and really try to make an impact. You know, we're already planning out our next show at for the 2022 show at CES, and you know, what are we going to bring? What are we going to keep trying to one up the you know, what we've brought in the past? And when we're looking at that, you know, that's where the advantage I think of having an innovation team that really is consistently and continually looking not just at today and tomorrow, but really utilizing, you know, a megatrends approach to start trying to understand what do people want? What type of problems are out there that we can solve? And that's something that I think we've done really, really well at here at GHSP is being able to identify problems, identify, you know, issues people are having and then bring a solution to it. And that's one of the things that I think has helped really propel some of the things that have really sparked public interest and done well for us at CES is just simply bringing a solution to you know, a problem or a, you know, a new way of looking at something. When you can really come to an event like that and you're bringing, you know, something unique that fixes people's problems, you know, that's what starts resonating.
Yeah. So does that stuff work? I mean, does it really drive the amount of interest, or is it like you use it in further marketing materials? Like, is it about, I mean, how much interest is driven at the actual event? Like, or does that drive sales and things like that?
Yeah. You know, that's always a tough thing. You know, we've just speaking recently with my team on, you know, planning out the next show and everything. I was trying to figure out even what the return is on a show. You know, how do you actually put a dollar amount to that for what you invest into it? Are we getting a return that's, you know, appropriate for what we're putting into it? And then, you know, how much buzz is good? And like you say, does it, you know, resonate beyond just what you're getting at the show? And for us, you know, we actually are a fairly new company to CES. You know, we've been there 4 years. We're coming up on a fifth year now. So compared to a lot of companies there that have a longstanding relationship with that show, you know, we're quite new at it. And so far, you know, one of the big drivers for that for us is brand recognition and trying to build our brand out of people understanding what we do, what we're about, and the uniqueness that we provide and provide our customers with. And so coming out of that show, we've done, I feel, a really good job of getting, you know, a lot of buzz that helps us open doors and bring in new business. So it's been very, very successful in that regard. An example of that is the inductive cooktop that we launched at the 2020 show. You know, we're in multiple development agreements now with appliance OEMs that, is really helping to further that division of our business.
Yeah, that's really fascinating. So, you know, looking forward, what's next on the horizon for GHSP?
So, you know, GHSP, as I've mentioned, is a continually evolving company. And, you know, when you go from stamping metal almost 100 years ago into clean rooms and printing your own circuit boards and cybersecurity and everything, it's an evolution that has really transformed our company here and helped transform a lot of things within, you know, several different markets. And some of the things that we're working on here that I think are going to continue that transformation is getting into health and wellness. You know, our UVC products are definitely, you know, moving us into that space. You know, we're able to start looking at utilizing some of the things that we've developed for other markets and start bringing them into helping people, you know, do everything from reduce carbon emissions to, you know, reduce, you know, germs in your environment and provide a safer home or automotive environment. There's just areas that we're looking at that I think are going to be a primary focus going forward that's really going to try to make an impact, you know, for really that health and wellness and safety and continuing also along in our automotive and appliance industries.
Recently, you all launched something that could be really cool for ambulances and police cars. Can you get into that a little bit?
Yeah, absolutely. So we launched a product called Greenlight, and that's the UVC product that I was referring to. What that does is provide a cleaner, safer, and more intelligent environment for people working in emergency services and, you know, police and you know, other types of emergency applications. As a start, and that product is now transitioning over into actual regular automotive and passenger car space as well. But one of the things that really makes that unique over just a product that can provide UVC light to kill germs in an environment is we actually provide a smart system that connects it to a cloud server system that we can help manage it with. So if you think about a pandemic is such a great, you know, and right at hand example, if we're looking at data and we're seeing that there's a spike in cases in a particular area, you know, through our cloud system, if we have a deployment of those vehicles in that area, we can actually adjust the amount of dosing time. We can monitor the system and make sure that things are being cleaned as appropriate and try to actually combat areas and beat down a spike of you know, a particular illness in that area. So it also provides a level of safety that most products like that just don't provide. And that's through everything from infrared sensors and motion sensors in the vehicle to make sure that people aren't being exposed to UVC light that could be harmful. And making sure that you know, the system runs a full safety protocol before it turns on. And then we actually have all that analytical data to be able to continually refine the system and make it even safer and more effective going forward.
You know, in your past, you you spent a bunch of time running an agency, and I'm curious how does that influence your thinking as it relates to marketing, as it relates to working with vendors, and all sorts of stuff like that.
Yeah, you know, coming out of actually owning and operating an agency for quite a number of years, it's just an interesting perspective to be able to be on both sides of the equation, from working with agencies and having worked as an agency, and just I think it gives a more rounded viewpoint of the marketing process and being able to hopefully understand it maybe a little bit better, and then also I think it gives a better perspective on how to be more effective with it. So it's another viewpoint that I try to use to my advantage as much as I can and for the companies that I'm working with.
What about like having worked so much in design work? Does that, do you think about, everything like a design project? I'd imagine that's hard to shake.
Yeah, it can be hard to shake, but, surrounding yourself with a team of really quality folks really makes that a whole lot easier. So, and at some level, you have to, trust the people that you've surrounded yourself with to, provide a high level of quality. And I'm fortunate that I've been able to do that. So I think it's something that you can use to your advantage and hopefully just help the team make the project even better.
Okay, let's get into our lightning round questions. These questions are fast and easy, just like marketing with Salesforce. You can go to salesforce.com/marketing to learn more about marketing on the world's number one CRM. That is Salesforce. Put your customer at the center of every interaction, automate engagement with each customer, and build your marketing strategy around the entire customer journey. Salesforce brings marketing engagement together. Learn more at salesforce.com/marketing. Lightning round questions, John. Are you ready?
I am ready.
Number one, do you have a favorite memory of your Tigers, the baseball team?
I do have a favorite memory, and it relates back to a previous employer that I was with. We had signed a manager from a competing baseball team as a spokesperson, but they used to play the Tigers all the time, and it allowed me to get on the field and spend a little more time with Tigers players, even though I was there with another team's manager. So, but it ended up being a lot of fun being down on the field and kind of hanging out in the ball club.
What is the best place to grab a cup of coffee in Michigan around where you live and where the company is at GHSP?
I'm going to go with... It's actually a place in Ann Arbor, Michigan called Ruse Roast. You have to get the lobster butter love coffee. And it's a pretty good place, real small. They do small batch roasting. The folks there, they know how to turn out a good bean. So it's a good place.
Over the years, what is one of your favorite marketing campaigns that you haven't done that you're jealous of?
I hate this to be somewhat cliche. I think the first one that comes to mind was the old Mac PC campaigns that Apple had done.
Sure.
They were entertaining. They seemed to catch. They had a lot of people following them. Anytime you can do a series that stretches over a significant amount of time, those tend to resonate and have a pretty good level of success. So they were fun to watch.
If you could have anyone in the world as a guest on a podcast, who would you want to interview?
I would probably go right now with Elon Musk, just the unique mind that I see there. There's a level of, he's not afraid to fail, which I think is refreshing in a lot of ways. And yet he's done exceedingly well in a variety of spaces. So that would be interesting just to sit down and be able to chat with him for a while.
If you weren't in marketing, if you weren't in business at all, what do you think you'd be doing?
I would probably be a chef. love cooking, kind of a foodie. And if I had to do it all over again, I don't know as I would change anything, but I would definitely probably take a few culinary courses back when I was in school, just for the fun of it.
Any favorite thing to cook?
I come from an Italian background, so probably stick with that. Have some longstanding traditions in my family at different holiday meals. And so I'll go specifically with a homemade lasagna that is enjoyed every Christmas in my family.
What's your best piece of advice for a first-time director of marketing?
Best advice is that I've given to a lot of people is never think you know it all. It's a world or that is always changing, and just like that, the marketing world is always changing. And being able to listen to everyone around you and understand that it's a continual learning process is something that I think typically will serve you well.
Well, that's it, John. That's all we got for today. Thanks so much for joining the show. We really appreciate it. Any final thoughts? Anything to plug?
Yeah, I really appreciate the time and enjoyed speaking with you. So looking forward to doing a little more with GHSP here, and looking forward to listening to more of your podcasts.
Appreciate it. Thanks so much. We always appreciate it. And thanks again for coming on.
All right. Thank you.
Marketing Trends Podcast is brought to you by Salesforce. Discover marketing built on the world's number one CRM, Salesforce. Put your customer at the center of every interaction. Automate engagement with each customer and build your marketing strategy around the entire customer journey. Salesforce, we bring marketing and engagement together. Learn more at salesforce.com/marketing.